Hello friends, myself Dr. Prem Shankar Pandey, founder and director of the Pearl Education, the pioneer of English literature subject preparation of competitive exams. Today, we are going to analyze the question paper of English literature conducted by UPSC on 28th of November 2021. So we are going to start with question number 31. I have also discussed the questions of general studies, which is there on my channel. So if you want to check the answers of the GS question, general studies question, you may see those questions in my channel. So the first question, question number 31 of English literature, Maya in Cry the Peacock is obsessed with the astrological prediction that the right option is her marriage will end in death in the fourth year. So an astrologer has made a prediction that on the fourth year of their marriage, she will die. So 31C is the right option. Question number 32, who is the presiding goddess of the village of Kantapura in Raja Rao novel of the same name Kantapura? The right option is Kenchamma. Kenchamma is the goddess of Kantapura. Moving on to question number 33, where did Raju in R.K. Narayan's The Guide go right after getting out of the jail? So the right answer here is to the barber. As you know that Raju was imprisoned for 2 days, and after he came out, his beard was a bit appeared on his cheek. So when he came out, the barber said that you are looking like Maharaja. So that is the right option. Otherwise, he has lots of thinking and finally he decided to go and sit on the bank of Sariu River. But here Sariu is not given as the option. So to the barber is the right answer here. Question number 34, which of the following is not a statement from Macaulay's Minute on Education? So the right option here is option number C. It would be good enough to consult their natives' intellectual taste at the expense of their intellectual health. So 34C is the right option. Question number 35. The persona in Sarojini Nayadu, the flute player of Brindavan, compares himself or herself with. Here the right option is a homeless bird. Question number 35 is homeless bird. Moving on to question number 36. In Chicago lecture, Swami Vivekanand alludes to the fable of a frog in a well. So he gave lots of stories, and this story, the fable of frog in a well, is about giving a hint at the cause of religious differences. So A is the right option for question number 36. Question number 37. In response to which of the following was Sri Aurobindo's Is India Civilized written? It was written in response to Sir William Archer's India and the Future. William Archer ki book thi, India and the Future, uske response mein Sri Aurobindo ne Is India Civilized likha tha. Question number 38. Which of the following linguistic term is associated with prescriptivism? So this is made from the word prescription. So variation is the right answer. Variation is the right answer for question number 38C. Question number 39. In Rasa theory, the external manifestation of a strongly felt emotion is called as. The right option is Vibhava. Option A. External manifestation is Vibhava. A strong emotion is called Asthai Bhav. But external manifestation is called as Vibhava. Question number 40. According to the Rasa school, Kavya and Natya are. I have a doubt in this question. As far as I know, the right options should be cousins. But if there is any variation in the answer, kindly let me know in the comment box. Question number 41. With reference to F.R. Lewis' literary criticism and philosophy, which of the following statements are correct or is correct? The first option, philosophy, we say, is concrete and poetry is abstract. This option itself is wrong because F.R. Lewis says that philosophy is abstract and poetry is concrete. Exactly opposite is the right. Whereas the second option, words in poetry invite us not to think about and judge, but to feel into or become. So the second is the right option according to F.R. Lewis. So 2 only is the right option. 41 is B, 2 only. Second option is the right one. Question number 42. The concept arch writing was developed by, right option is Jack Derrida. A is the right option. Question number 43. Text is considered to be autotelic by new critics. Autotelic is the right answer. 43 is C. Question number 44. According to Frederick Jameson, postmodern culture is associated with imperialist capitalism. Imperialist capitalism is the right answer here. Question number 45. Who has developed the term strategic essentialism? This term was coined by postcolonial author Gayatri Chakravarti Spivak. So 45 is C is the right option. I sit in the top of the wood, my eyes closed. So this first line of the hawk in the rain, the right option is hawk, because I is used for hawk. C is the right option, 46C. Question number 47, who of the following was not a predecessor of William Shakespeare? So as you know, all the university wits, Green, Marlowe, Lodge, they were the predecessors. Ben Jonson was the contemporary of William Shakespeare. So Ben Jonson is the right answer. Question number 48, the first book of Common Prayer. The first book of Common Prayer was issued in the year 1549. C is the right option. Question number 49, which three Germanian tribes invaded Britons in the 5th century AD, bringing them to the roots of modern English? The right option is the Jutes, Angles and Saxons. B is the right option. Question number 50. Make me thy lyre, even as the forest is. What if my leaves are falling like its own? The tumult of thy mighty harmonies will take from both a deep autumnal tone, sweet though in sadness. So these lines are taken from P.B. Shelley's Ode to the West Wind. In the above quote, the word both refers to, here the both refers to the poet's persona and the autumn. Poet's persona, persona and the autumn. Okay, next question. In Browning's poem, My Last Duchess. In the My Last Duchess, the name of the painter, Fra Pandolf, is used three times, thrice. 51 is C is the right option. Question number 52. Fill in the blank with the right option. The display an aversion of literal language, which might presume one-to-one correspondence between words and things. As far as I know, the right option should be Victorians, but I have a doubt in this option. If you find the right option, kindly let me know in the comment box. Let's move on to question number 53. Which of the following texts of the Oxford movement is not correctly matched? So John Henry Newman has written Loss and Gain, that is correct. And Gerard Manley Hopkins written The Rake of the Dutch Lands is correct. John Cable has written The Christian is correct. Scenes of Critical Life. There is no such book existing. Scenes of Critical Life. Scenes of Clerical Life is by George Eliot. So B should be the right option. However, Charlotte Mary Young has not written Scenes of Critical Life. So it's a controversial question. It may, objection may come, but yes, once three options are correct, so B should be the right option. Otherwise, Scenes of Clerical Life is written by George Eliot. Question number 54. The three sections of the play Lion and the Jewel are named as Morning, Noon and Night. D is the right option. 54 is D. Question number 55. Complete the following statement with the most appropriate choice. Chinua Achebe's Things Fall Apart. It questions Western understanding of Christianity because Christian missionaries were settled in Igbo community in the Things Fall Apart. So A is the right option here. Question number 56. Peter Porter's Your Attention, Please is a poem about apocalypse, government and society. A is the right option for question number 56. Question number 57. Which of the following novels is associated with Christian? In none of the novel you will find Christian as a character. However, in the Pilgrim's Progress Vanity Fair episode, you will find the character Christian. So it is again a controversial question. If you find the right answer to this question, kindly let me know. Otherwise, if you go through the options, none of the options are right. In none of the novels, you will find the character Christian. However, because the question is asking which of the following novels by William Thackeray, Vanity Fair, there is no character as Christian, neither in Sense and Sensibility, The Vicar of Wakefield, and Sibyl. Question number 58, which of the following is an example of campus novel? So as you know, it's Lucky Jim. C is the right option. Question number 58 is C. Question number 59, whose novels are called the novels of manners? So all the novels of Jane Austen are known as novel of manners. B is the right option. In Margaret Atwood's Surfacing, the fish is a symbol of, the fish is a symbol of unity and wholeness here. C is the right option here. Question number 61. The plays of which of the following Euro-American playwrights cannot be described as a theater of the absurd? So Samuel Beckett, Jean Genet, Eugene Ionesco. These three are the absurd writers. They are from the school of the theater of the absurd. Edward Bond is the right option. 61 is C. Question number 62. Which of the following correctly describes Indian Queen? So Indian Queen is a heroic tragedy in rhyme couplet written by John Dryden and Robert Howard. The right option is C, 62 is C. Question number 63. T's Eliot phrase dissociation of sensibility occurs in his essay entitled The Metaphysical Poets. D is the right option. Question number 64. In which of the following plays does Bobadil appears? So Bobadil appears in Every Man in His Humor by Ben Jonson. Question number 65. Who of the following English sovereigns was deeply interested in witchcraft? Deeply interested. So James I was really frightened of the witches. So he was interested with the witchcraft. James I is the right option. 65 is C. Question number 66. In Beckett's Waiting for Godot, who are waiting for Godot? So Vladimir and Estragon. That's the right option. B is the right option. Question number 67. To which festival does the title of the play Twelfth Night refer? Here, Twelfth Night refers to Christmas festival, which is also known as Epiphany of the Eve of the Epiphany. Christmas is also called as of the Epiphany. So Epiphany is the right option here. 67 is A. Which of the following is the right description of Mirabel? Mirabel is represented as an undisguised materialism. He does not do any kind of changing his personality. He is a clear-cut personality. So D is the right option. He has in him an attraction for undisguised materialism. So D is the right option. Question number 69. To which Greek mythological character is Dr. Faustus compared in the prologue to the play Dr. Faustus? So Dr. Faustus is compared with Icarus, Greek mythological character Icarus. C is the right option here. Question number 70. T.S. Eliot's murder in the cathedral drew on an eyewitness to the event, a clerk named. The clerk is named as Edward Green. C is the right option. Moving on to question number 71. In which of the following plays do the below given line appears? A politician is the devil's quitted anvil. He fashions all sins on him and the blows are never heard. So this line appears in John Webster's The Duchess of Malfi. C is the right option. 71 is C. Question number 72. Which of the Claudius and Laertes traps for Hamlet succeeds in killing him? So Laertes takes a poisoned sword and kills Hamlet. So D is the right option here. Question number 73. Which of the following is not a part of tragedy according to Aristotle? So according to Aristotle, fable or plot, a spectacle, diction. These three are the parts of the tragedy where imitation is not a part of tragedy. There are six parts of tragedy defined by Aristotle. Imitation is not there. Fable, there is a confusion between fable and imitation. So fable is also called as plot. So that is the right option. So imitation is the right option here. 73 C. Imitation is not a part of tragedy. Question number 74. In which year does the play Saint Joan of opens? The first act, first scene of Saint Joan opens in 1429. B is the right option. Which term has been used by Matthew Arnold in his Culture and Anarchy for the middle classes? So he has used Philistines for as a middle class, barbarian as the aristocrat class or the topmost class, populace as the lowest or working class. Philistines is the right option. 75 is B. How many phonemes are there in the word sum? So if you look at the dictionary, you will find sa, a, and ma. There are three phonemes. Sum is made of three phonemes, sa, a, and ma. So the right option is three. Three phonemes are there. Question number 77. In My Place, Sally Morgan tries to eliminate. You know, My Place is an autobiographical context of Sally Morgan. So there she talks about the personal feelings of bitterness. She is trying to eliminate personal feelings of bitterness. A is the right option. Question number 78. Formulating general hypothesis about language change comes under the branch of linguistic called as historical linguistic. Historical linguistic is the right option here. Question number 79. Complete the statement given below with an appropriate option. Saussure believed that a synchronic explanation of things demonstrate how all the forms and meanings are interrelated. The right option is D, at a particular point of time. Synchronic means at a particular point of time. Diachronic means with the historical event, with the time and space. So D is the right option, at a particular point of time in a particular language system. Question number 80. Which of the following is not correct in respect of Wallace Stevens' 13 ways of looking at a blackboard? Option A, the poem has 13 short in equal but separate sections. That is right. Stanza 2 and 12 consist of two lines each. That is wrong. Stanza 3 and 12 are of two lines each. So that is the wrong option here. Rest all are the right option. So not correct is B. It is B. Question number 81. A foot consisting of one stressed followed by an unstressed syllabus is known as trochee. Trochee is the right option here. Question number 82. Milton, in his Paradise Lost, Book 1, has written and justifies the ways of God to man. What is the subject of the verb justify in the next text of the poem? So here, John Milton calls the heavenly muse as a spirit, and he said that the spirit should help him so that he can justify the ways of God to man. So I is the right option here. A is the right option here. Question number 83. Question number 83, identify the rheme in the following sentence. What is rheme? Rheme is anything that talks about the theme of a particular clause. So here there are two clauses, yesterday and Paul went for a walk. So went for a walk is the main theme for the clause. Paul went for a walk. So C is the right option, went for a walk. Question number 84, identify the word having a wrong phonetic transcription. The wrong transcription, B, abject. Abject is not written like this. B is the right option here in 84. Question number 85. Which of the following is an absolute characteristics of English for a specific purpose according to Dewdley Evans? Here 85C is the right option. ESP is created on the language appropriate to these activities in terms of grammar, lexis, register, study, skills, discourse, and genre. Question number 86. Words ending with bound morpheme logi have the primary stress on the, so you know bound morphemes are those morphemes with the syllables the cannot be segregated, it cannot be separated. So in the bound morpheme, the stress is on the preceding syllable of logi, preceding syllable. If it is not a bound morpheme, free morpheme, then the stress will be on the root word of the suffix. But here the right option is immediately preceding the terms. Immediately is the right option here. In 1798 edition of the Lyrical Ballads did not contain which of the following? It was published anonymously, so name of the either poet was totally missing. 87HC. Question number 88. Who of the following distinguishes between the text of pleasure and the bliss. In the case of the author, Roland Barthes has distinguished between the text of pleasure and the text of bliss. Roland Barthes, A is the right option. Question number 89.
What two images does Emily Dickinson use to symbolize success, and success counted sweetest? Here the right option is the nectar and the victorious army. 89, option number C. Question number 90. O powerful Western star, in the above line of Walt Whitman poem, when lilacs last in a bromeliad bloom, the fallen star refers to? It refers to Abraham Lincoln. B is the right option. Question number 91. In which of the following novels does one come across the line, a pure hand needs no glove to cover it? This line has been taken from The Scarlet Letter. 91, option number A is the right option. Question number 92. Who is Santiago's model in The Old Man and the Sea? The Old Man and the Sea, Santiago's model is his assistant Manolin. So 92, D is the right option. Question number 93. He who was living is now dead. We who were living are now dying with a little patience. This line has been taken from T.S. Eliot's The Wasteland. Here, he is used for the Christ who was dead. So Christ is the right option here. Question number 94. How many stories each pilgrim was supposed to tell in the Canterbury Tales? Altogether, four stories were to be told by each pilgrim. Two from going from Tabardine to Canterbury and two from returning back. So four stories is the right answer. 94 is D. Question number 95. Specify the source of the title of the novel Far From the Madding Crowd. Far From the Madding Crowd has been taken from the line from Elegy Written in a Country Churchyard by Thomas Gray. C is the right option here. Question number 96. In writing The Glass Menagerie, Tennessee Williams drew on the earliest screenplay he had written. Identify the title of the screenplay from the following. He has written the screenplay The Gentleman Caller, and the same theme has been used by him in writing the novel The Glass Menagerie. So The Gentleman Caller, option A, is the right option. Question number 97. Which of the following is not correct with reference to Gandhi's Hind Swaraj? As you know, Gandhi's Hind Swaraj was published in 1909, where Gandhi is arguing about the different arguments. Whereas A option, Gandhi is arguing with the extremists who want to make a violent revolution, is not correct. So the right option here is 97A. A is the right option for 97. Question number 98. Raja Rao maintains that telling the Indian tale in English involves, for 98, the right option is C, a knowledge of religions and a spiritual text. As you know, in Kantapura, there is a description of Hari Katha told by Jayaram Achar. So a lot of religious and spiritual texts are mentioned. So 98C is the right option. Question number 99, true poetry according to Sri Aurobindo. Sri Aurobindo says that the true poetry is like a divine mantra. So B is the right option for 99. And question number 100. In Sasi Deshpande's That Long Silence, Joya is renamed as. So after her marriage, her name was changed from Joya to Suhasini. So B is the right option. So 100 is B. So these were the 100 questions. I have discussed 30 questions of general paper in this separate video. And this video consists of question number 31 to 100. As per my evaluation is concerned, I feel that if you have scored 65 questions altogether in this paper, including general, 65 out of 100, then it is an excellent score. The cutoff may vary from 60 to 65 for the general, 60 to 65 for the general, and 55 to 57 for OBC, and 48 to 50 for SCST category. So if you have scored 60 and between 60 and 65, it's an excellent score. 100% chances of the call for interview. If below 60, that may be a boundary line case. So this is my interpretation. If any options you feel is different, or if you feel any option is wrong, kindly say in the comment box. Put your answer in the comment box. And also share your scores. That will give you a clear-cut idea to every scholar in the comment box. So that's all from my side.